Hello fellow D&D adventurers, Ryan here from D&D Awakening. Today we bring you episode 5 of our first ever adventure into the world of Dungeons & Dragons, with episode 6, The Crossing. As dawn rose in the distance, our adventurers woke. One by one, they congregated around the pile of burned bodies.
Burned flesh, what a beautiful morning smell, said Bjorn.
Nothing better, replied Melkor.
Where's Henrik?
Asked Hailman.
Wasn't he on watch?
Knowing Henrik, he's falling asleep somewhere, hee-hee, Allegna chuckled. The remaining party members scoured the clearing for Henrik, but they couldn't find him. The only thing they found was a cart track heading out of the clearing, back towards the road.
It appears another of my brethren have been taken, Bjorn said. I will have revenge on those who did this. We continue to Copperweights, said Melkor. I'm sure we will find out what has happened to the barbarians. I'm sure we will.
With that, the remaining party members gathered up their belongings and returned to the road, heading toward Lord Copperweight's. They travelled all day up the road. The only people upon the road appeared to be locals fetching wood from the surrounding forest, but none admitted to seeing anyone pass this way, including any carts. At midday, they reached a bridge with a lone man upon it. He was tall and carried a sword on his back. As the party approached, Dane spoke up.
Hello, good sir. We are in search of Lord Copperweight's manor, and are in search of a few of our missing brethren. I don't suppose you are in any way able to help us?
My name is Sir Orlick von Lichtenstein of Gardaland. I will help you in your journey if one of your party can best me in single combat, he said.
Give us a minute,
Dane said.
What should we do?
Said Riv.
We need to best him and keep moving as quick as we can, said Bjorn. I will fight him. This will be over quick.
Bjorn moved forward and drew his sword.
To the death,
he asked.
Ha! No, not to the death, my friend. I will not be responsible for your death today. Just to first blood.
So be it,
Bjorn replied before pouncing at his foe.
It was over swiftly. Bjorn swung his sword down in a short arc, but in the blink of an eye,
Sir Ulrich moved to one side and used the butt of his sword to smash Bjorn in the face, knocking him to the floor, Ulrich's sword at his throat.
Is there any other who will fight me?
Said Sir Ulrich.
Combat has been honoured already, and I will let you pass. But if you wish to fight, then let's duel.
Surprising everyone, Riv stepped up, a manic grin on her lips.
I will fight you, Sir Ulrich!
With that, Riv picked up a short sword that was in the ground, while Melkor gave Bjorn a hand to his feet.
Ha, little one, you're brave! To make this fair, I will fight on my knees,
said Sir Ulrich. Riv didn't wait and charged at her foe. She charged left and right, avoiding blows from her opponent. She parried one blow and then a second, surprising everyone. She seemed to do well. It became obvious that Sir Ulrich was going easy on Riv, but her skills were still improving. The big surprise was when she leapt over Sir Ulrich's head after stabbing the sword into the ground, simultaneously pulling a dagger from her belt and holding it to the neck of Sir Ulrich. Everyone cheered, none more so than Bjorn. The cheers swiftly turned to laughter, including from Ulrich.
Well done, little one, Sir Ulrich announced. You are indeed brave and very nimble. I fear for any that would call you enemy, he laughed. Now, how can I help you? You said you were in search of your friends. Who are they?
Hailman stepped forward and spoke first, while Bjorn and the rest congratulated Riv on her victory.
We are in search of our missing barbarians. They have led me to believe that the missing barbarians have something to do with Lord Copperweight. We are heading to his manor now to find them. Can you help us?
At hearing this, Sir Ulrich frowned.
I too have heard of the missing barbarians, but I have heard of no connection between Lord Copperweight and them going missing. But if it is his manor you seek, then you are on the right path. If you follow this path for several miles, you will come to a fork in the road. Take the left path, and it will lead you to his manor. It is less than half a day's walk from here.
Ah, how do we know we can trust you? Asked Allegna.
You don't, replied Sir Ulrich. But I am an honourable man. I could have killed you all here and now, but I haven't. I am, or should I say, was a knight of the Order of Light.
Was?
Asked Dane.
Yes, I was, he replied.
After the wars in the north, I settled down to a quiet life. I now travel the land looking for honourable jewels, and you were indeed honourable.
One last question, asked Bjorn.
Have you seen any carts or barbarians heading this way, or towards Lord Copperweight's?
Daily, said Sir Ulrich.
But I pay the carts no attention. It's not my place to question the lords within these lands. The last cart I saw pass this way was this morning, but it was dark, and they were at a distance. I never saw who was riding the cart or how many occupants were inside.
With that, the party said their farewells and continued their journey. They continued for several hours, first passing the fork in the road before finally arriving at what appeared to be a vast estate. In the centre was a massive manor. To the west was a stable by an enormous lake, and to the east was a stone building, roughly a quarter of a mile away from the manor itself. It was quiet. No one appeared to be in the area. It was then a man in leather armour, similar to the bandits they had met on the road previously, left the stone building to the west and headed towards the main building itself.
"What now?"
asked Dane.
"We wait till dark," replied Bjorn. "Then we pay Lord Copperweight a brief visit."
They waited in the trees to the east of the road till it was dark. The only movement was the guards and bandits passing from the stone building to the main manor. As they watched, they decided at dark they would enter the stone building to see what was going on inside. After that, they would look to enter the manor itself and find Lord Copperweight.
"Let's move," said Bjorn.
They moved swiftly towards the stone building, disguised by the night sky. One guard was outside the building, but nothing else. Within seconds, the guard lay dead on the ground. Two arrows through his neck, one from Allegna, and a second from Dane. Melkor, Bjorn, and Allegna went inside while Riv, Dane, and Hailman headed to the side of the manor, looking to use their small size to sneak inside undetected. The three party members breached the stone building's front door, Bjorn and Melkor leading the way, followed by Allegna. Weapons raised, they were swift. Inside the stone building appeared to be a guard barrack. To the left was a cage. Inside, conscious, was both Henrik and Helmut. To the right were eight bedchambers. Our adventurers charged inside. Bjorn headed to the cage as Melkor, swiftly followed by Allegna, moved towards the guard area. Within seconds, Bjorn had released Henrik and Helmut, and in moments, it was carnage. The four barbarians fighting side by side made quick work of the eight guards within the room. In one swing, Bjorn cleaved two guards in half. Henrik, in a rage, had charged the closest guard, screaming,
"Where's Steve? I need to know where Steve is!"
The guard just swung his sword at Henrik, but he was too slow. Henrik was in such a rage, he planted a barbarian kiss on the guard, headbutting him and knocking him unconscious before he took his sword. Allegna fired her bow, killing one guard instantly, before stringing her bow a second time and killing a second in as many heartbeats. Helmut Halfhand picked up a spear from the ground and threw it at one guard, striking him in the chest. The throw was so hard it pinned the guard to the wall as he slowly bled out. It left two single guards against Melkor. As Melkor approached, they both looked at him. Within seconds, they dropped to their knees and apologized while begging for forgiveness. Neither put up a fight. Melkor just stared at them both, spat the words,
"Failures and fools,"
before spitting at them as he swung his axe, decapitating them both in one blow.
"Henrik! Helmut, we are so glad you are alive!"
Bjorn shouted as he took the arm of Henrik, Melkor taking Helmut's hand as Melkor looked deep into Helmut's eyes before they smiled knowingly at each other.
"What happened?" Bjorn asked.
"I don't know," Henrik said.
"I only woke up a short while ago.
The last thing I remember was taking a slash in the woods. I heard a noise and the next it went black."
"How long have I been here?" he said.
"It's only been a day," replied Bjorn. "We set off at dawn when we realized you were missing."
"Good to see you too, Helmut. Do you know anything about what is happening?"
"Good to see you too," replied Helmut. "I arrived here yesterday. There was two other barbarians in here with me. Before they placed Henrik here with me, they took the others away. I don't know where."
"Whatever we do, we need to join the others outside. And soon," said Allegna.
"I agree. Let's end this now,"
replied Melkor. Helmut and Henrik collected their weapons, which they found in a wooden chest inside the barracks. They all moved outside. There was just enough light coming from the manor's upstairs windows to see their three companions climbing inside. So, my fellow adventurers, this brings a conclusion to episode 6. Episode 7 will bring to a conclusion this entire adventure. Where are the missing barbarians? Who is Lord Copperweight? Who is Steve that Henrik is talking about? Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified when we upload our final episode in our adventure next week. And to end it with a blast, it will be an extended episode. Take care, and I'll see you all in the next one.